हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट रीडिंग द चैप्टर नंबर 5th इन द सेकंड टेक्स्ट बुक विस्टास। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर नंबर 5th एज यू कैन सी हियर इज शुड विजर्ड हिट मॉमी। ओके, एंड दिस द चैप्टर रिटन बाय जॉन अपडाइक। द चैप्टर इज रियली हाईली मीनिंगफुल एंड educative to all of us, so we must read this the chapter quite attentively and sincerely. We must focus on each and every word. Before you read, here is a story about the world view of a little child and the difficult moral question she raises during the story session with her father. So what does this the outline tell us better? This the outline tell us something about the theme of this story. Through this outline it is told to us that the story which we are going to read, okay, explores a very big and comprehensive view of a little child. Such a view which is totally different. Such a view, such a thought which is totally different from the adult ones, from all other human beings. And this the little child also raises the difficult moral question during the story session, with her father. When she is quite busy in attending the story being told to her by her father, she also puts a very difficult question based on morality. And the child is very little in her age. She is a 4-year-old child, but she asks her father regarding such kinds of things which can hardly be, okay, which can hardly be expected from the highly intelligent and matured persons. First of all, beta, I would like to give you a short chapter sketch. Beta, in this chapter, apart from the things which are connected to the family of the protagonist, of the narrator of this chapter, whose name is Jack, we are also told here most of the facts regarding the second protagonist, whose name is here Roger Skunk. Especially this the chapter, this the story is written about a tiny wild creature named Roger Skunk. And Jack, who is a storyteller, also gives us some important information and details regarding the members of his family, regarding the overall attitude of his daughter. And he also tells us what kinds of things are seen, what kinds of things are arranged here, okay, in his house. So these the facts will surely appear before us when we will be reading this the chapter. But the main part, okay, of this chapter lies in the story concerning to the life of Roger Skunk, concerning to the nature and behavior of this the wild creature. So while telling this the story, Jack tells his daughter, whose name is Joe, and who is a 4-year-old child, that once upon a time there was a wild tiny little creature named Roger Skunk. He used to live with his family members in a forest, okay beta, in a woodland. Since he smelled very bad, no other creature, little creature, used to play with him. So he found himself totally humiliated, insulted, since he was totally neglected, and he was often called, okay, sticky skunk, okay, in Hindi, badbudar skunk. So when he was called, when he was insulted, calling Stinky Skunk, so he he did not feel happy. He did not feel happy, and he felt himself so much humiliated. So one day he thought that he should find out the solution of his problem, since he was really in a very big problem. So while getting the solution of his problem, he started walking down the road. He started walking down that the densely wooded forest, and all of a sudden he happened to see an old owl there sitting on a tree, on the top of a tree. So when he consulted that the old owl regarding his problem, so owl told him that he should go to the wizard, the magician, who lived there over the creek, over the little stream, in a little house, and he could really solve his problem. Following the words of that the old owl, the poor little creature, who was really mentally disturbed, visited the house, went there, visited the house of the wizard and met him, and he also reported the whole matter before him. The wizard also sensed so, and he told him that he would like to solve his problem, but he demanded some pennies from him, and especially he had demanded the pennies for the charges for the fee of solving his problem, in the amount which much more amount which the poor creature had at that time with him. So again the little creature Roger Skunk found himself in a big dilemma, complicated situation, and he could not think what he should do. But at the same time that the wizard helped him find out the solution of that problem also, and he told him that he should go to a place where he could find some more pennies, so that he could pay him as for his fee charges, and he solved his problem. So before he started solving problem, he chanted some magical words, and then he after muttering some magical words, he also asked him what kind of smell he would like to take. So he was told that he would like to take the smell of roses, a very sweet smell. So the wizard again performed his magic spell, and he changed the foul smell of his body into the smell of roses, and the poor creature felt so much happy, delighted, and he came back to his home. When he met his mother better, so his mother smelt him differently, and she got so much angry, and she asked him why he had got his natural smell changed into the smell of roses. So the whole matter was explained by Roger Skunk. So being so much furious, she told him that he should take her to the wizard, to that stupid wizard who had changed his natural smell into the smell of roses. And she went there, and while arguing with the wizard, she also hit his head with her umbrella. And at that part, Joe also objected, saying that she should not have hit the head of the wizard with an umbrella, because it was totally illegal, and it was not feasible, impractical for a mother, and it was totally the direct insult of the wizard, as well as the feeling of the little child also, little creature also, since the little creature was again changed into the foul smell, and he was not accepted by the other. But when he had got his foul smell changed into the sweet smell of roses, so he was accepted by all the little creatures living in the woodland, and he started playing with them with so much happiness, But when he had gone his home and reported the whole matter before his mother, so his mother went back to his mother, accompanied by her little child, went back to the wizard and told him that he should not have changed his natural smell into the smell of roses, and she also scolded him, and she even hit his head with her umbrella, and it was really very insulting matter for the wizard as well as for the little Roger Skunk, and Joe objected it, saying that she should not have done so, because little Roger Skunk was changed again, was his smell, sweet smell was again changed by the magician into the foul smell, and thereafter he was not accepted by the other members of the forest, and he felt so much delighted. No, sorry, he felt so much sad and upset. He became so much depressed at that time, and looking at finding him or getting him that the little Roger Skunk into much depression, Joe objected to saying it that the story should be ended with some different kind of description, and it should be ended that Roger Skunk's mother's head was hit by the wizard, and his foul smell again was changed into the smell of roses by the wizard, by the magician, so that he could be able to play with other animals. So she always stressed, emphasized that the feelings of the youngsters, feelings of the little children must be given full importance, much more importance than that of the feelings of the elders, because they had also their own rights and freedom. So these kinds of things are written here in the story, and the story is really quite amusing and so much humorous. So we should take it quite interestingly. Okay, better let's start reading it. In the evenings and for Saturday naps, the word naps stands for here are two words, jij, z-i-double-z, jij, snooze, s-n-double-o-z, snooze, and the last word is here, short sleep, feel sleepy. In the evenings and for Saturday naps, like today, Jack told his daughter Jo a story out of his head. Out of his head means self-coined, self-made, fabricated story. In the evenings and for Saturday naps, like today's. Like the day, Jo was going to tell one more story to his little daughter Jo. Especially on the evening of Saturday, Jack used to tell a story to his daughter Jo, which he had made by himself using his own skills, own abilities. So we may get some other explanation in some other sense. Almost every day on the late evening hours, Jack, a storyteller, used to tell a story to his little child Joe, in order to entertain her so that she could easily fall into heavy sleep and enjoy a sound sleep also. So it could be called the bedtime stories, because at that time Joe was about to go to her bed, and she was about to fall asleep. But in order to make her feel sleepy, Jack used to tell her his fabricated story in the evening hours, dark evening hours, almost every day. But on Saturday evening, he had to tell a story. By hook or by crook, he had to tell a story at any cost. He never missed the evening of Saturday. That day had been fixed for her. This custom stands for practice, tradition. This is the tradition of telling the stories, fabricated stories, bedtime stories, had begun. The word had is not mentioned here, but I would like to add here. Begun when she was two. Had begun when Joe was only 2 years old. When Joe was only 2 years old, her father Jack had started the practice of telling the stories to her. Was itself now nearly 2 years old. Since he had started the practice of telling the stories to his daughter Joe when she was 2 years old. So now 2 years have passed since he started That's the practice of telling the stories. So now the age of Joe is 4 years old. It means when Joe was 2 years old, the practice that the custom had begun, and now 2 years have passed since the custom, since that the practice was started by Jack. So now here, 2 years have passed. It means Jack had been telling his fabricated bedtime stories to his daughter Joe for the last 2 years. Okay. And his head felt empty. Since he had been telling his fabricated, self-coined, okay, bedtime stories for the last 2 years, his head had got almost emptied, exhausted. He could hardly arrange some words to make a new story. Each new story was a slight variation of a basic tale. When Jack made his new story, so he used to show a little bit difference, okay, a little bit change compared to his basic tale, his main story. He never told the story in the same manner as he had told it previously. He wanted to show a little difference in his new story. Every time when he used to make a new story, he used to show a bit change in the character or in the formation of his story beta. A small creature usually named Roger. Basically, he used his main character in his each and every story, and the name of that main character was Roger. Whenever he framed any story, he used to give place to this creature Roger in his story. So he kept that the Roger as the central part of his story in each and every story. A small creature usually named Roger. Roger fish, Roger squirrel, Roger chipmunk. So sometimes he used to give the name of his story, okay, Roger's fish. Sometimes he used to tell the story on the name of Roger squirrel. Sometimes he used to tell the story on the name of Roger chipmunk. So he every time he used to change the name of the story. So now this time the story he was telling to his little daughter Joe was regarding a new kind of creature, namely Roger skunk. The name skunk will appear before us in the next, okay, on the next page. At the next page, I'm sorry. The owl told him to go. Sorry, had some problem. So now we should connect this part with the word. A small creature usually named Roger had some problem. The main protagonist of Jack's story, Roger, had some problem. He had some problem in his life and went with it to the wise old owl. So attached with that problem, having that the problem in his life, Roger went to meet the wild old owl. One day he decided to meet some wise creature, and all of a sudden he happened to see a very wise old owl sitting on the top of a tree, and he discussed with it. The owl told him to go to the wizard, and the wizard performed a magic spell. When the poor Roger skunk met the old owl, so he was advised to go to the wizard. The word wizard stands for here a kind of magician, okay, magician. He was advised that he should meet a magician very immediately in order to get his problem solved, and the wizard performed a magic spell. And when the poor Roger skunk met the wizard, that the magician, wherever he lived, all the parts of this story will appear before us in the, okay, at the next page. The wizard performed, okay, some introductory part of the story are mentioned here, no? The wizard performed a magic spell. So that the wizard performed a magic spell. Magic spell stands for air beater. The word magic spells orally spoken magical words. Okay, so when the poor Roger Skunk met him, so the wizard told him that he should. Firstly, the magician, okay, spelled out some magical words, verbal formula of speaking out the magical words. Magic spell stands for a verbal formula. Verbally spelled out some magical words. Okay, that solved the problem. And as soon as the magician, that the wizard, spelled out some magical words, so the problem of Roger Skunk was finally solved out. Demanding in payment a number of pennies. The word what pennies stands for here, 100th of a pound, or it may also be considered as a cent. Okay, it is a unit of currency. Demanding in payment a number of pennies greater than the number that Roger creature had. Okay, so that the wizard, that the magician also demanded so many pennies, which fell short, okay, in the pocket of Roger creature, and he had demanded greater than the number the Roger creature had. So he had demanded so many pennies as for his charges that the Roger creature did not have. But in the same breath, directing the animal to a place where the extra pennies could be found. But at the same moment, the magician also told the poor creature that he should go to a place where he could find some extra pennies which he required to pay him for his fee. Then Roger was so happy, he played many games with other creatures. When the problem of the poor creature Roger Skunk was solved out by the magician, he found himself totally lucky, fully lucky to play with the other little creatures in the forest, in the wood, in the deep wood. Dense wood, okay, woodland, and went home to his mother just in time to hear the train whistle. And having played with his friends, he finally went his home, okay, to live with his mother just in time. Well, in time, hearing the sound of the whistle of the train. That brought his daddy home from Boston. When he heard the sound of the whistle of the train, so he found it out on his part that his daddy, that his father, had really come his home from Boston, and he came back to his home. Jack described their supper. The word supper stands for an evening meal. Okay, a meal which is cooked and served in the evening time before night. Jack also described in the story regarding the evening meal also, and the story was over. And in this manner, he finished the story. Working his way through this scheme was especially fatiguing on Saturday. Since Jack had been telling such kind of bedtime stories for the last 2 years, so working in this manner through that the two year long old scheme tradition, okay, working his way through this scheme was especially fatiguing on Saturday. Now what fatiguing stands for here? Tiresome, exhausting. Jack found it on his part that he had really been so much exhausted while telling the stories to his daughter Jo for the last 2 years, especially on Saturday evenings, because Jo never fell asleep while listening to the story. Jo never fell asleep, and she used to remain awake, okay, and she did not fall herself in heavy sleep, though the main intention of Jack was in order to make her feel sleepy and make her sleep soundly. And knowing this made the rite seem futile. The word futile means useless. The rite stands for a bit of customary practice. customary practice. Customary practice means tradition. And knowing this made the rite seem futile. And he also came to know, he also learnt it on his part that the practice had become so much useless for him, because he had started that the practice of telling the stories to his daughter Joe, thinking that through that bedtime story he would be able to make his daughter Joe fall asleep. But he could not be able, and he felt himself totally unable in getting positive results in his customary practice. So he found it out on his part finally that it all, knowing this made the rite seem futile, means he knew it very well that the 2 year long customary practice had been made quite useless for him by his 2 year old daughter Joe. Okay beta, now the rest part of this chapter will be attended by us in the next lecture, and keep studying very hard, because since you are the students of class 12, and you must set only single one goal of your life to get to score the full marks, not excellent marks but full marks in each and every subject. Okay, all the best of luck. Thank you. Be cheerful.